welcome to Kazakhstan.
So after a 26-hour bus ride from China, we arrived in Kazakhstan, crossing our first land border and paying our first bribe along the way. The changes were immediate. We were staying in Soviet-era apartments in Almaty, and after checking out town, we headed up to see what the local ski resorts had to offer.
When you're sliding down the slope and the wind is blowing and everything just, you know, goes so fast, and even though you might fall sometimes, but that feeling that you're going so fast, it keeps you going, it kind of pushes you even further, I think.
Pretty open to traveling through Central Asia, really. My sister and a few friends had done it previously, and I think traveling with boys is probably a bit safer just from some of the stories that we've heard. We're always having to break trail for them, you know, be out in front.
They do pull through a few times though, sometimes.
Ladies.
In a few days I'm heading back to New Zealand to go back to the real world. This trip's been amazing and I've seen so many incredible things. It'll be sad to say goodbye to everyone, but I wish them all the best for the rest of the trip.
Yeah.
heading into Kyrgyzstan, which is one of the most mountainous countries in the world, we'd heard about this guy Ryan from Colorado, who was running this epic backcountry operation called 40 Tribes.
So we're at the eastern edge of the Issaquel Valley. We're in the Tersca-Alto Mountains, and we've set up a backcountry yurt here at about 2,600 meters or so. We've got access to a number of peaks right behind us. The summits are at about 3,400, 3,600 meters, and we've got epic skiing. The idea behind 40 Tribes is that we are working in partnership with the village that's at the base of these mountains. It's called Kyrgyzstan. It's a ton of fun. It's always a new experience. And in the mountains, you know, around every corner is something new. All as one.
Despite multiple gear failures, nighttime temperatures of below minus 30, and a mystery illness ripping through the group, the yurt still felt like a home away from home. Based out of the yurt for 5 days was an amazing experience. Incredible mountains and epic skiing right at the doorstep. Something we're never going to forget. Oh.